This is probably the most important of all the Isshin Ryu Karate tapes. The tape on the fundamentals of the Okinawan Isshin Ryu system. This tape features the first things students learn when they enter a karate dojo of Isshin Ryu Karate. Master Uezu will teach you the basic 15 upper body exercises. Upper body meaning punches and blocks. Number one. Straight punch or lunge punch. In Japanese, oizuki. Stepping. Right foot. Punching out into the solar plexus and retracting the punch slightly back. When striking, you hit with the top two knuckles. Utilizing the vertical Isshin Ryu punch. Tremendous power is executed by the master. Target, solar plexus, or ribs.
Ace!
The stance is Seisan Dachi. Circle step. Set feet straight ahead, shoulders width apart. Number two. Lunging, uppercut. Jodan oizuki.
2번. Jodan oizuki.
Step left foot. As your hand leaves your hip, turn. Knuckles up, smashing under the opponent's jaw. You're also striking between the eyes and under the nose. Watch carefully and follow along at home. Very powerful snap, like a bullwhip. Strike out and back. Keep the fist tight. Application. Now, Gayakazuki, reverse punch. This time, step out left foot, strike right hand, step right foot, strike left hand. Straight out into the solar plexus, vertical punch, keep the fist straight, strike out, 99% of the arm is out, and a slight retraction. This is what gives you that tremendous power in Isshin Ryu and snap. Number three, reverse punch application. Stepping left foot, striking. Notice how the master executes the kiai or karate shout.
4번. 조단 약츠키.
Reverse uppercut. Reverse means opposite foot, opposite hand. Tremendous power, striking underneath the jaw, cracking and breaking the attacker's jaw. Snapping out, with the arm 99% straight and whipping back. Application of number 4. Isshin Ryu students throughout the world must know these basics. Strike under the jaw or into the nose. The reason the elbow comes back is to protect the rib cage. His opponent cannot punch when the elbow retracts for protection. Now, number 5. Number 5 starts the blocks. Girambarai, stepping back right foot, down block with the forearm muscle. Counter solar plexus. Notice the perfect form. Even when the master does it slow, you can feel his power. Notice the step back. It's a circular step back. Seisan stance, feet shoulders width apart, knees slightly bent, weight in the center. 50% of your weight is on each leg. Concentrate on watching the down block now. The down block is executed with the forearm muscle. Application. Blocking against the kick to the groin or solar plexus. Now the next one is the side block. Stepping back, chudanuki. Block with the forearm muscle. Counter into the solar plexus. Notice how the block covers the entire front of the body. Whenever you block or punch, set first in your stance, complete the block and the counter. As you punch, retract the block at the same exact time. This will give you extra power, speed. The master's so powerful, he reverberates. Application of the side block. Now, number 7. Shuro-uki, stepping back, open hand side block, counter, straight fingertips, or nukite, as it is referred to in Japanese. You block with the open side of your hand. Open hand blocks are used in Isshin Ryu, so you can grab and hold on to your opponent's wrist. Slight retraction after the fingertip strike. Devastating power. Those fingertips will puncture your skin. Watch carefully. Application now against an opponent. Number 8 is your first head block, open hand head block. Counter uppercut to the jaw. Again, open hand is for grabbing your opponent's punching arm. Circle step back, set solid. Always do each side equally. At least 4 or 5 with each side. 4 slow, 4 full power. Next technique, number 9.
上段腕受け。上段突き。
Stepping back, tight-fisted head block, blocking with the forearm muscle. Reverse punch into the body, into the solar plexus. Slow again, the master performs. Notice the arc of the head block. He keeps it at an angle so the punch rolls off. The punch he's blocking. Again, an application. Number 10.
10番。通段裏打ち。通段突き。
Head block. Off the block. Break the attacker's nose. Straight punch into his solar plexus. Block. Snap the nose. Straight punch into the solar plexus. You're hitting your opponent twice on number 10. You must know these for belt rank. This tape is required for your yellow belt. Application of number 10. Notice, head block, break his nose, straight punch.
11番、ゲラン払い、連続突き。
Number 11. This time, stepping forward and blocking down. 5 quick punches into the opponent's rib cage, midsection solar plex area. Down block with the forearm muscle. You're blocking a kick or punch to the groin and 5 quick punches into the body. Excellent speed drill. Application. Number
12. 6番、12番、通段受け連続突き。
The same as number 11, but side block, 5 punches into the body. Side block with the forearm muscle. Now fast. Watch the application. Number
13. 手形払い。中段手形払い。手刀抜く。手形打ち。
Open hand down block, open hand, strike the neck. Shudo down block, shudo across the attacker's neck. Follow at home. Application now. Open hand block a kick, open hand block a punch to the body, quick counters to the neck.
14番、大打ち。
Number 14, uruts, or roundhouse punches. You're coming around in an arc, striking your opponent with the two large knuckles of the fist. You block first and counter. Notice how he turns the top of his hand inward to accentuate the knuckles. Application. Striking into the solar plexus and kidneys. Can be used as simple self-defense against a lapel hold, striking the ribs, and roundhouse punches into the temple. Now, number 15 is called breaking the bear hug from the cat stance, which is called Niko Achidachi. Someone's grabbing you from behind. You're stepping back in between their legs, breaking their grip, hitting them with your hip. Watch carefully. The attack comes. Now, to break his grip, you step back, block in case an attacker is in front, block his punch, hit the guy behind with your elbow. That completes the upper body techniques of Isshin Ryu Karate, the 15. Now, some important tips about upper body. Let's take a close look at the Isshin Ryu punch, the famous vertical punch. This is the action of the punch as the master steps in with either right or left foot. The punch comes straight off the hip. When you make the fist, the thumb is on top. You're striking with the two large knuckles. The punch extends out 99% straight, not 100%. You don't want to lock out your elbow and jar your elbow. And then there's a slight retraction from the power of the punch. Now the uppercut comes under the jaw, elbow comes back down to protect the ribs. It turns off the hip, break the jaw, coming back, protecting the ribs. Uppercut is number 3 and 4 in the upper body exercises. As you can see, it's also used to strike under the nose. This will very quickly break the attacker's nose. Under the jaw again. Now, those were not all the blocks and punches of Isshin Ryu Karate. There are hundreds more. They are the fundamental techniques that get you started. These are other blocks that you will be getting involved with. Outside inward block. Come across with the forearm, counter to the ribs. Another one. Double blocks with the same hand. Open hand technique, redirecting your opponent. So as you can see, Isshin Ryu is very involved. Many of these advanced techniques will be taught in the kata tapes, which are required for all your belt ranks. Notice how he controls his opponent with one hand, blocking both punches. He counters into the rib cage with the vertical punch. Again, these are additional blocks. Before you do these, you must learn the basic upper body, the 15 upper body punches and blocks of Isshin Ryu. Another block is to redirect the punch. Slap it away with your palm, counter to the jaw. Open hand blocks a kick. Block a head punch, counter to the stomach, rib area. As you can see, it gets more advanced as you go. But you must learn to crawl before you can walk, and walk before you can run. Everything is a step-by-step process. Block open palm, catch the punch, counter to the ribs. Another blocking technique, forearm block against a roundhouse kick, counter back knuckle, and reverse punch to the body. Now we come to the lower body exercises of Isshin Ryu. There are 15 of them. Lower body refers to kicking techniques.
Isshin Ryu Karate Do, 基本, 足の部, 一番, 足の筋の部.
Now, before kicking, you must warm up properly. Number one, lower body is simply touching your palms to the floor. Keep your toes curled up. Number two, put your palms behind your back. Keep your knees straight, stretch forward, and pull way back, pulling the chin back. Number three, leg extension, balancing on one foot. Hold the toes and extend out without losing your balance. All classes go through these formal exercises in Isshin Ryu. Number four, wide squat leg stretch. Turn your palms out, fingers together. Touch your butt to the floor. Bounce 3, 4, 5 times each side. Of course, more repetitions are done, but for time's sake, you're shown a few. Number five, your first kick, front snap kick to the solar plexus with the ball of the foot. This kick can also be used to the knee, groin, jaw. It's a snapping kick. Knee up high, so retract quickly. Keep the toes back. Look at the power. Tremendous speed, concentrate on speed. Application. Right to the solar plexus. Variations are to the ribs, jaw. Of course, the groin. The kneecap. Number six, 45 degree blade kick to the knee.
5番, 速投蹴り.
Striking with the blade area and heel area of the foot. A quick snapping motion. Watch the application. You can strike to the inside or the outside of the knee. It takes little effort to break someone's kneecap. Number 7 is the cross over heel stomp, komi-komi in Japanese. Devastating infighting technique, as you will see. Execute this by bringing your knee up high, driving your heel into the attacker's knee. Strike the side of the knee. Now we have the side kick. From a strong seisan stance, bring the knee up high, strike out with the blade of the foot directly to your side. Very slight hip movement, turn the hip slightly at the opponent as you kick. Snap. Application. As the attack comes to the side, blast. You can outreach your opponent's fist. Next technique is Nikoachidachi. From Seisan stance, you turn into a cat stance, putting all your weight on the rear foot. The front leg is up on the ball of the foot, ready to front kick. Turn your torso as you set. Snap, power. Application, turn to meet your attacker, counter with the front kick. Targets the solar plexus. Now we come to number 10. Leaning to the side, front kick into the solar plexus. You lean away from the opponent's attack, away from his punch. Twist your shoulder around, both hands on the opposite hip. Counter with the ball of the foot. Avoid the attack and counter. Sidestep kick. Watch the application now. The attack comes, shift away, your opponent's wide open for a kick. The next leg technique is the heel push kick. This is an in-close fighting technique. If someone grabs you by the lapels or wrist, you drive your heel into his solar plexus, pushing him away. It's not a snapping kick, it's a thrusting kick, a driving kick. The application now, attacker grabs, heal up, knock him off, push him away. Next technique is the knee smash. This shows you how to drive the knee into the attacker. Hold your hand out. It acts as a target. Could be the attacker's groin or solar plexus. You're in very close. Drive the point of the knee straight up. As you strike, keep your instep back. Now we have the basic back kick. Looking over the kicking side shoulder, drive your heel straight back into your opponent. As a beginner, you're taught with your hands on your hips. But as you get more advanced, you'll be putting your guard up as you execute the techniques. The punch comes in. Master kicks straight back with the heel. The back kick is one of the most powerful and destructive kicks. Notice the reach it has over the punch. Deep breathing exercises revitalizes you. Next is push-ups. The push-ups are done with the hands placed shoulders width apart, and you do it on the Isshin Ryu fist. This helps tighten the knuckles and, of course, build punching power. On the last repetition, look up and stretch. And a few jumps. Next are body twists. This is like a cool down exercise after doing all the kicks. Just swing your leg up high as your arms go the opposite way. Do about five each leg. And lower body ends with deep breathing exercise. Step out, breathe in through your nose deep, fill your lungs. Arms up and drop forward. Exhale out the mouth. This will help revitalize you. Again, those were just the basic kicking techniques. There are hundreds of kicks in Isshin Ryu. The master will now teach you the sport kicks, the extra kicks that you will graduate to. But before he does, he wants to show you some advanced stretching. You should go through the stretching routine with your partner before attempting these kicks. But do not try these kicks unless you have mastered the basic lower body exercises of Isshin Ryu. Don't jump ahead. Now, sitting back to back. Work your way up your opponent's back, bringing his head to the floor. Keep your legs apart. These are advanced stretching routines, so take it easy. Don't attempt them unless you're pretty flexible. You've been stretching for at least 3 months. Now, with your opponent on the floor, hold his pant leg down with one foot and stretch forward, straight back. Then go to the knee, and this will help loosen his hip. Now the other side. Of course, you want to do each side equally. Don't favor one over the other. Stretch the hip. Now the master works on loosening the back and actually entire upper body. Push down on the insteps, loosens the knees and thighs. Shake it out, keep them loose. Massage, loosen up the hamstrings and calf muscles. Now for some more advanced stretching against the wall, partner stretches. Put your partner against the wall with his back. Raise his leg, front kick position, and work it up towards the wall. When your toes can touch the top of the wall, you're pretty flexible. That'll take a little time for most of you. Stretch the foot up. Keep the knee locked. Very slow bounce. Bring the foot back in. Toes up and push the knee up. This will loosen the hip and groin muscles. Put your opponent next to the wall sideways. And side kick stretch, keeping the foot in the blade position. Make sure your partner has perfect form in the foot and overhaul stretching technique. Form is very important to get the maximum effect. And do the other side. When you're done with these techniques, you're pretty warmed up. You did the front, side, now let's do the back. Raise the leg, keep the knee straight, and work your partner's leg up. From there, lock arms, and just rock your opponent on your back. This will help him get all the kinks out of his back and shoulders.
Yes.
Okay, fingers together. Side squat and stretch. Then go to the other side. You go through this routine, you'll probably never pull a muscle again. Work out your splits. Keep your feet flat on the floor. Palms down. And bring your chin to the floor, concentrating on the stretch, not daydreaming. Turn to the side for a side split. Hold for about 5 seconds. Work the other side. Grab your legs and pull your head to your knees. This will loosen up your lower back and hamstrings. Grab the instep, concentrate on your balance and stretch. Other side. You should be following along at home. Raise the knee up, swing it up high, help loosen up the hip and groin muscles. Keep the leg stiff, swing it over your head. Alternating, do each side equally. Rotate the shoulders. Deep breathing. It's the same exact technique that you just saw in the lower body exercises. You are now ready to begin the advanced techniques of Isshin Ryu kicking. Driving front kick from the rear leg. Very destructive kick. Watch the application. Regular stance won't reach, so you must shuffle and drive the kick from the rear. As you shuffle, bring the leg up, execute the kick, striking with the ball of the foot.
Number two, my ass. Stress, my yeri.
Now the front kick again, shuffling. Yes. This time, executing the kick off the lead leg. Keep the toes curled back. Strike with the ball of the foot. All your body weight's behind the kick. This kick will go right through your opponent if you connect full power. Next technique, shuffle up, cross behind, side kick. Step behind. Drive your weight behind the kick. Drive in. As you step behind, point your hip at your opponent. Bring the knee up high. Execute. All at the same time. Slow motion. Now, side kick from the rear leg. Trigger the knee up high. Drive the blade at your opponent. Cannot reach. Purpose of the kick is to shuffle and strike. As you can see, these are excellent for free sparring competition. They cover distance. They add tremendous power to your technique. Very strong. Now, shuffle in side kick with the front leg. Watch. Very common kick. Slow motion. Watch the impact. Now, hook kick. It's a hooking side kick. What you're doing is angling off. Confusing your opponent. You're working the kick in around his guard. Now, hopping side kick. You're constantly moving, and then the explosion. You throw your whole body into the kick. Hopping and skip in. Watch. How would you like to have that kick coming at you? Now, mawashigeri, or roundhouse kick from the back leg, striking with the instep of the foot. Watch carefully. Tremendous snap. It's also used with the ball of the foot. Either way is fine. The most common way is with the top of the foot. Now, mawashigeri, or roundhouse kick with the front lead leg. The front lead is used for speed. Very hard kick to block. The technique is to shuffle up, knee up high, and a quick snap with the instep. The ball of the foot is also used. Again, the instep is more common, less injuries to the foot. Now, the back kick. As the attacker comes in, kick straight back with the heel. From the standard back kick to the spinning back kick. One of the many kicking techniques of Isshin Ryu. As the attacker comes in, spin, drive your heel into the body, into the ribs, solar plexus. Now, the hook kick. Cross behind, hook the heel around and in. The heel is a devastating weapon. Very powerful, also used to the face. Hook to the body and face. Now the spinning hook kick. Similar to the spinning back kick, whipping your heel around, hooking into the body. It's not a straight-on kick. It comes around and in, like a hook punch. All your body weight is behind it. He fakes with a front kick, throws the hook kick. Now, feet together, explosive short side kick. Feet together, roundhouse kick. Skipping in, very short, quick movement. Application, watch carefully. Heels together, can't reach. Shuffle in. Jump side kick. Fake, jump, drive the blade into the attacker's jaw. Play that back and watch it over and over. Here's one you should try. Jump spinning back kick. Double front kick. Fake low, front kick high into the solar plexus chest area. Fake low, high roundhouse. Tobiokogeri, flying side kick. Step up, strike the jaw. Slow motion, 1-2 steps. The master will now teach you yakusoku kumite, an excellent reflex training drill. He developed these drills himself for the Isshin Ryu student. There are five of them. Number one. These teach you how to react defensively and offensively in any situation. They're prearranged and they must be learned for your green belt. Number two. Blocking two kicks, open hand, head block, punch. If your opponent blocks the punch. Number three. Block the side kick, block the roundhouse, head block, and your punch is blocked. Your punch to the ribs is blocked. Number four. Quickly. Roundhouse block, side kick, spinning back kick, counter roundhouse. And number five. You must know these. All the attacks and counters. Work on them. Koteki Tai, conditioning drills. These are body toughening drills. They're required for green belts. First thing, roll up the sleeves on your uniform. As your opponent punches, he twists his forearm up. And you condition by striking the top of the forearm with an open hand chop. Next one is the side block, grab, twist the forearm muscle up, and open hand chop. Conditioning exercises. Do not strike the elbow or wrist. Strike the muscle part of the forearm. Next technique is side block and down block contact. Again, with the muscle of the forearm. Conditioning, start with five each and then build up to like 50 repetitions each side. Next technique is partner isometric breathing. This technique is excellent for developing upper body strength in your punching and blocking techniques. The master inhales through the nose, exhales as he tries to push his opponent's hand down. Make your opponent work. Don't be easy on your partner. It's resistance training. As you push down, he makes you work to get it down 1 inch. Now, they do the other side. Inhale, exhale as you try and push down. Circular, rotate. Makiwara knuckle conditioning training. In Okinawa, this is a very big part of a student's training, is to callus the knuckles. Make sure you have a good, strong makiwara. You punch into a leather or straw or canvas pad. As you hit with the Isshin Ryu punch, twist the knuckle, turning the hand to the floor. This twist will add callus to your knuckles. Start out hitting it 25 times each hand a day then build up to 100, 200, 300, 500 times a day each hand. More advanced technique is to drive your punch into the wood. Shuffle in, punch, twist. Combination striking to condition the knuckles. Back knuckle, straight punch, twist. Back knuckle, straight punch, twist. Only the two large knuckles should make contact. Also condition the side of the hand by striking the top of the makiwara. Hit the wood and then rub back and forth a couple times. Hit the sides of the pad. It's also used to develop the areas of the foot, callus the ball of the foot and side blade of the foot. Strike groin height. Start out easy and build up. Then kick into the pad area. Side kick, striking with the blade, callusing the blade or edge of the foot.